Young people are suggested that you should name this book Shit Happens, Deal With It. Listen to them without advising, without lecturing. Most important thing is be there, show up. Stigma means I don't talk about it. If I have depression, I don't talk about it because I feel there's something wrong with me. Either one extreme is I'm mad, or you're weak, or you're just creating drama, right? So it's madness, weakness, or drama. And that's why I've written this book. This is about so that everybody, suppose anybody's going through it, person can say, you know what, I'm struggling with depression right now, or, you know, I'm struggling with anxiety right now, or there is OCD sometimes I struggle with. And imagine if we are able to bring it in our everyday conversation, we can talk about it, how much of a difference it will make to the person who's going through it. On one hand, deal with depression, but it makes it 10 times worse when there's so much of shame around it. And shame is a very, you know, we don't understand, shame is one of the most difficult emotions to live with. Anybody who's going through suffering, who's going through difficult times, and they start defining themselves by that, they lose their sense of personal agency. They start thinking, I can't do anything. You know, I go to a psychiatrist will help me. I go to a therapist will help me. Or situation needs to change. Or my family needs to change. My husband needs to change. My children need to change. Everything else needs to change, but I can't change. One of the main focus in therapy, when I work with anybody, is getting that sense of personal agency. As a therapist, there's a lot of sense of despair also. However, one thing that has really, the biggest thing has made is a turning point is when the person gets a sense of personal agency. It's not, I'm here because of myself, not because of my parents. Human beings are wired to connect. We are wired to be part of a community. And many times, depression, anxiety robs us of that, isolates us. And the role of the family, friends, is to reach out, be there for them, listen to them without advising, without lecturing. The other thing is, people need to become more aware. That's why I've written this book. This is for carers, this is for people, young people, old people, everybody to read this book, to understand what those people are going through and what they can do. There will be times when you will feel worn out, when you will feel, I can't help at all, you know? But most important thing is be there, show up. And one of the young people suggested that you should name this book, Shit Happens, Deal With It. You know, so yeah, shit happens in people's life, but deal with it and be there for them. I call them three D's. One is dismissing. Dismissing means, you know, snap out of it. If you only tried, you don't try. If you try and you have the strength, you would be able to do it. Or look at that person. That person, you know, is going through cancer, but still is smiling. Why can't you? You know, you talk about depression. What is depression? It's just a choice. Happiness is a choice too. You can choose not to have depression. The other thing is dumping. Dumping is where whatever the person might be going through, you say, oh, this person is depressed, that's why the person is doing that. A lot of time, women, because of the, you know, the social, cultural, political context and what they have to face, sometimes they go through difficult situations in life and immediately they're labeled as depressed. The third D I talk about is defining. Defining is when we let that single story of depression, anxiety, OCD, anorexia, whatever the person might be going through, define that person. You take a petri dish, you put depression in, and you take away shame, you take away stigma, you take away silence from it, and you see it resolve, right? So that's why I'm very strongly in my book. In fact, that's the cover, which says, going beyond silence, shame, and stigma in mental health. Because that's the way we reclaim our lives.